Welcome to War India News Hour. Can anyone be made accountable for the growing data theft across the globe? The year 2020 has been a challenging year. I'm sure almost all of you must have had a range of experiences how the pandemic has impacted your personal and business life. Future of Connected Living reveals that the device-to-person ratio will exceed 20:1 by 2030 as the world enters the era of hyper-connectivity and catapults organizations' digital transformation. The number of connected devices globally is projected to increase from 30.4 billion in 2020 to 200 billion in 2030 at a compound annual growth rate of 20.7%. The demand for connected living will primarily be driven by advanced software technology, widespread content streaming and network integration. The rising demand is projected to quadruple smart and connected home penetration over the next 5 years to reach over 18% by 2025. Spending on the smart city sector is expected to reach $327 billion by 2025, up at a strong CAGR of 22.7%, and will lead to higher adoption of technologies such as artificial intelligence and 5G. Now, a question arises, who will be the custodian of the digital democracy? Disinformation and propaganda disseminated online is poisoning the public sphere. Fake news data collection is the challenge to democracy. To survive in a hyper-connected era, companies must ensure that their products and services are not only connected but also intuitive, conversant and intelligent. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. TRAI suspends pesky SMS regulation for 7 days. The Telecom Regulatory Authority of India suspended the implementation of the Unsolicited Commercial Communication, that is UCC, framework that caused massive disruption in Unified Payments Interface, that is UPI, Aadhaar-enabled payments, that is AEPS, net banking and credit card payments, among others. The new distributed ledger technology, that is DLT, deployed by telecom operators, checks the sender ID and content of every commercial SMS originating from a registered source, while SMSs from unregistered senders are simply blocked by the new platform. Microsoft's $7.5 billion ZeniMax Media acquisition gets green signal. The European Commission has given its clearance to Microsoft to acquire ZeniMax Media for a $7.5 billion deal. The Bethesda parent company ZeniMax Media was founded in 1999 by Chairman and CEO Robert Altman. The Bethesda deal will bring future games to its Xbox Game Pass subscription. Creators of critically acclaimed and best-selling gaming franchises, including The Elder Scrolls and Fallout, among many others, Bethesda brings an impressive portfolio of games, technology, talent, as well as a track record of blockbuster commercial success to Xbox. As per sources, Microsoft appears to be planning to keep Bethesda running separately with its existing leadership. Huawei to explore joint venture partnership with Indian company for technology transfer for 5G. Chinese technology equipment maker Huawei is willing to partner an Indian company in 5G equipment manufacturing, including transfer of technology, to assuage any security concerns that India may have. We are now very much open and willing to partner with a local company. We are looking for a local partner, and for commercial reasons, we don't want to disclose any details, Huawei India CEO David Li said. He called on the government to provide a level playing field. Apple to shift up to 10% manufacturing capacity out of China. Apple is already manufacturing the iPhone SE, iPhone XR and iPhone 11 in India through its contract partners. Now, Apple is planning to commence iPhone 12 manufacturing in India and in the process of shifting 7 to 10% of the manufacturing capacity of the devices in India. Additionally, these made in India iPhone 12 models would be available for purchase in the domestic and international markets and could help the Cupertino-based giant in avoiding hefty import taxes. Is Bitcoin set to hit an all-time high of $60,000 this week? The Bitcoin price is likely to hit an all-time high of $60,000 this week as the U.S. House of Representatives is expected to pass Democrats' $1.9 trillion stimulus bill this week, predicts the CEO of one of the world's largest independent financial advisory and fintech organizations. The cryptocurrency hit a market capitalization of $1 trillion on Tuesday as prices reached $54,900 on the DeVere Crypto Exchange app, which comes just short of February's $58,000 all-time high. Banks write off rupees 1.15 lakh crores in 9 months of the financial year 21, says minister. Banks have written off bad loans to rupees 1.15 lakh crore during the first 3 quarters of the current fiscal. As per RBI guidelines and policy approved by bank boards, non-performing loans, including those in respect of which full provisioning has been made on completion of 4 years, are removed from the balance sheet of the bank concerned by way of write-off, Minister of State for Finance Anurag Singh Thakur said. China raises issue at WTO over the app ban and FDI curbs. China expressed deep concern over the restrictions of 200 Chinese apps at the World Trade Organization. China said that such measures were not consistent with WTO non-discrimination principle. It further added that the Chinese app ban has caused negative consequences for the supply chain and local consumers. It also spoke on the restrictions on opportunistic takeover of Indian companies post-COVID, terming them as to be inconsistent with multilateral trade rules and cautioning that they may affect business interests on both sides. Bill Gates invests $22 million into Israeli startup H2 Pro. In a bid to make cheap green hydrogen, Israel-based green hydrogen startup H2 Pro has raised $22 million from funds backed by Bill Gates, Microsoft founder, and Hong Kong billionaire Lee Ka-shing. Founded in 2019, H2 Pro's technology, E-TAC, uses electricity to split water and generate hydrogen and oxygen separately in different steps. Japan's Sumitomo and automaker Hyundai Motors also participated in the funding. Hydrogen will likely be a crucial part of decarbonizing industries like steel and cement, and perhaps also shipping and aviation, given the limits of current battery technology. Hike CEO Kevin Mittal to sell his stake in gaming platform Winzo. In 2019, Hike had invested $3 million in Winzo as part of its Series A investment, which also saw Kalari Capital pumping in money. Now, Kevin Mittal is looking to get back in the games with two new products, that is Vibe, an exclusive social platform, and Rush, a gaming platform. Winzo confirmed the companies are working towards a complete exit of Hike from the cap table. Lee Jianjun appointed as the Chief Executive Officer of ZTE. The appointment of Lee Jianjun as the CEO replacing Yang Jiao comes at a time when the Chinese company is struggling to grow its business in the country. The new Chief Executive has been in India for many years and handled various telecom operations in the country. Sources said that ZTE this year applied for the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, that is DPIIT, approval for its participation in BSNL's Phase 9 tenders, upcoming request for proposals. Summing up, the future home will become a central hub for connected living as it allows homes to evolve into on-demand workspaces and much more. Continued advancements in connectivity technologies such as cloud services, Internet of Things, video conferencing, mobility, robotics, and AI will create innovation frontiers for connected technology and service providers. The convergence of 5G and Wi-Fi 6 will be a crucial enabler for connectivity as they will improve communication network speed, customer experience, and long-term cost efficiency. The connected home of the future will anticipate resident behavior and adjust the home environment accordingly. Seamless connectivity will also facilitate the standardization of platforms across the intelligent device ecosystem. To succeed in the connected era, companies cannot do it alone. Enterprises need to establish new partnerships, engage with a broader ecosystem, and explore new business models to deliver a unique value proposition. While connected living drives digital resilience, it also carries major risks such as data insecurity and vulnerability to cyber attacks. Therefore, organizations are encouraged to develop a detailed cybersecurity strategy that will align with their goals and facilitate the provision of secure connected services to customers anywhere. It helps organizations identify a continuous flow of growth opportunities to succeed in an unpredictable future. That's it for the day. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.